morning. Now we are going to see the training process. I am B. Mohmed Fazil, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering from Sedi Institute of Technology. Grinding is the most common form of abrasive machining. It is a material cutting process which engages an abrasive tool whose cutting elements are grains of abrasive material known as grit. These grits are characterized by sharp cutting points, high hardness, chemical stability and wear resistance. The grids are held together by a suitable bonding material to give shape of an abrasive as tool. Advantages. Yeah, grinding wheel requires two types of specification: dimensional accuracy, good surface finish, good form and locational accuracy applicable to both hardened and unhardened materials. Applications: surface finishing, slitting and potting, descaling, deburring, stock removal, finishing of flats as well as cylindrical, grinding of tools, cutters of abrasive of the frame. Surface grinding. In surface grinding, the spindle portion is either horizontal or vertical, and the relative motion of the workpiece is achieved either by reciprocating the workpiece by pause the wheel or by rotating it. These possible combinations of spindle orientations and workpiece motions yield four types of surface grinding process illustrated in the figure. If you look at the figure 1, the grinding wheel is rotated and the workpot is moved in longitudinal direction. And if you look at the diagram 2, the grinding wheel rotates and the workpot also rotates. If you look at the diagram 3, the grinding wheel rotates and the workpot is moved in the longitudinal direction. If you look at the diagram 4, the grinding wheel rotates and the workpiece also rotates in a rotational motion. Surface grinding machine. These are the parts of the surface grinding machine: wheel guard, wheel head, column, bed, feed. Feed is nothing but the movement of the workpiece in a transverse direction. The saddle is used for holding the work table. The work table is where the workpiece is held. This is the bed. This is the bed where the workpiece is placed and it can be moved in longitudinal directions. Surface grinding machine. The machine may be similar to a milling machine used mainly to grind flat surfaces. However, some type of surface grinders are also capable of producing counter surfaces formed of grinding wheels. If you look at diagram A, A is a rotation of the grinding wheel. B denotes the reciprocation of the work table. C denotes the transverse feed. D denotes the down feed. The two diagrams are horizontal grinding machine and the vertical grinding machine. If you look at the horizontal grinding machine, the workpiece is moved in the transverse and longitudinal direction. If you look at the vertical grinding machine, the workpiece can be moved in vertical. Grinding wheel is moved in the up and downward direction. Cylindrical grinding machine. In this operation, the external or internal cylindrical surface of a workpiece are ground. In external grinding, also called center type grinding, the workpiece rotates and reciprocates along its axis, although for large and long work parts, the grinding wheel reciprocates. In internal grinding, a small wheel grinds the inside of the diameter of the part. The workpiece is held in a rotating chuck in the headstock and the wheel rotates at very high rotational speed. In this operation, the workpiece rotates and the grinding wheel reciprocates. If you look at the diagram, the grinding wheel rotates and the workpiece is moved. Cylindrical workpiece is grinded in this diagram 1. And if you look at the diagram 2, the work part rotates and the grinder is fed in a crossfeed directions, in a longitudinal direction. If you look at this diagram, cylindrical grinding machine, A denotes the rotation of the grinding wheel. B denotes the work table rotation. C denotes the reciprocation of work table. D denotes infeed. This diagram is an internal grinding machine. The machine is used to produce internal cylindrical surface. Surface may be straight, tapered, or grooved or profile. If you look at this diagram, A denotes the rotation of the workpiece. B denotes the rotation of the reciprocable. C denotes the reciprocation of work table. D denotes the infeed. Next one is centerless grinding. Centerless grinding is a process for continuously grinding cylindrical surface in which the workpiece is supported not by centers or chucks but by a rest blade. The workpiece is ground between two wheels. The larger grinding wheel does grinding, while the smaller regulating wheel, which is tilted at an angle I, regulates the velocity Vf of the axial movement of the workpiece. Centerless grind can also be external or internal, transverse feed or plunge grinding. The most kind of common type of central grinding is the external transverse feed grinding. If you look at this diagram, the workpiece is placed over a small work table, and the regulating wheel is used so that the workpiece also rotates and the grinding wheel rotates in the opposite direction. Thus, the material is removed in this process. Grinding wheel. Next one is grinding wheel. Grinding wheel consists of hard abrasive grains called grits, which perform the cutting or removal, material removal held in the weak bonding matrix. A grinding wheel commonly identified by the type of abrasive material used. The conventional wheels include aluminum oxide, silicon carbide wheels, while diamond and cubic boron nitride wheels fall in the category of super abrasive wheel. Specification of grinding wheel. A grinding wheel requires two types of specification: geometrical specification. Next one is compositional specification. Geometrical specification. This is decided by the type of grinding machine and the grinding operation to be performed on the workpiece. This specification mainly includes wheel diameter, width and depth of the rim and bore diameter. Compositional specification. Specification of grinding wheel ordinarily means compositional specification. Conventional abrasive grinding wheels are specified encompassing the following parameters: the type of the grit material, the grit size, the bond strength of the wheel, commonly known as wheel hardness, the structure of the wheel denoting the porosity, that is the amount of intergrid spacing, the type of bond material. Other than parameters, the wheel manufacturers may be added the own identification code, prefix or suffix, both the standards. Examples of bonded abrasives. Conventional abrasives are aluminum oxide and silicon carbide. Super abrasives are cubic boron nitride, CBN or diamond. Selection of cutting speed and work speed is based on material to be ground and hardness, amount of stock removal and finish required, whether the grinding is done wet or dry, wheel speed, area of grinding contact, severity of the grinding operation. Turing and dressing of grinding wheel. Turing is the act of regenerating the required geometry on the grind wheel, whether the geometry is special form or flat profile. Therefore, turing produces a macro geometry of the grind wheel. Turing is also required on new conventional wheel to ensure consistency with the specific mounting system. In practice, the effective macro geometry of a grinding wheel is of vital importance, and accuracy of the finished workpiece is directly related to the effective wheel geometry. Dressing. Dressing is a conditioning on the wheel surface which ensures that grit cutting edges are exposed from the bond and thus able to penetrate into the workpiece material. Also, in dressing, attempts are made to splinter the abrasive grinds to make them sharp and free cutting, and also to remove any residue left by the material beyond ground. Dressing therefore produces microgeometry. The structure of the microgeometry of grinding wheel determines its cutting ability with the wheel of given composition. Dressing can be sustainably influenced the condition of the grinding tool. Turing and dressing are commonly combined in one operation for conventional abrasive grinding wheels, but are usually two distinctly separate operations for super abrasive wheels. Finishing operation. To ensure reliable performance and prolonged service life of modern machinery, its component required to be manufactured not only with high dimensional geometrical accuracy, but also with high surface finish. Surface finish has a wider role in influencing functional characteristics like wear resistance, fatigue resistance, corrosion resistance and power loss due to friction. The finishing operation are assigned as the last operation in the single part production cycle, usually after the conventional or abrasive machining operation, but also the net shape process such as powder metallurgy, cold forging. Finishing operation: lapping, buffing, honing, super finishing, wire brushing, polishing, electro polishing, magnetic field assisted polishing. Lapping. In lapping, instead of bonded abrasive tool, oil-based fluid suspension of very small abrasives, aluminum oxide, silicon carbide, which typically grit size between 300 to 600, called lapping component, is applied between the workpiece and the lapping tool. The lapping tool is called lap, which is made of soft material like copper, lead or wood. The lap has reverse of the desired shape of the work part. To accomplish the process, the lap is pressed against the work and moved back and forth over the surface. Lapping is sometimes performed by hand, but lapping machine accomplishes the highest efficiency. Lapping is regarded as the oldest method of obtaining fine finish. Lapping is basically an abrasive process in which loose abrasive function as a cutting point find momentary support from the laps. Material removed in lapping usually ranges from 0.003 to 0.03 mm, but many reach to 0.08 to 0.1 mm in certain cases. The cutting mechanism in lapping is abrasive become embedded in the lap surface, and the cutting action is very similar to grinding, but the concurrent cutting action of the free abrasive particles in the fluid cannot be excluded. Lapping is used to produce optical lenses, metal bearing surfaces, gadgets and other devices, and the finishes are an extreme accuracy. Characteristics: use of loose abrasive between lap and the workpiece. Usually lap and workpiece are not partially driven but are guided in contact with each other. Relative motion between the lap and the work should change continuously so that the path of the abrasive grains of the lap is not repeated on the workpiece. abrasives of lapping. Aluminium oxide silicon carbide of grain size of 5 to 100 micrometer. Chromium oxide grain size of 1 to 2 micrometer. Boron carbide of grain size 5 to 60 micrometer. Diamond grain size of 0.5 to 5 micrometer. Lubricating materials of lapping: machine oil, wrap oil, grease. Technique of abrasion affecting the lapping process are: unit pressure, the grain size of the abrasive, the concentration of the abrasive in the vehicle, lapping speed. Polishing. Polishing is a finishing operation to improve the surface finish by means of a polishing wheel made of fabrics or leather and rotating at high speed. The abrasive grains are glued to the outer periphery of the polishing wheel. The polishing operation are often accomplished manually. Buffing. Buffing is an operation, finishing operation similar to polishing, in which the abrasive grains are not glued to the wheel but are contained in buffing component that is pressed into the outside surface of the buffing wheel while it rotates. As in polishing, the abrasive particles must be periodically replenished. As in polishing, buffing is usually done manually, although machines may have been designed to perform the process automatically. Buffing wheels are made of discs of linen, cotton, broad cloth and canvas. Honing. Honing is a finishing operation in which a tool can hone carries out a combined rotary and reciprocating motion while the workpiece does not perform any working motion. Most of the honing is done on internal cylindrical surface such as automobile cylindrical walls. The honing stones are held against the workpiece with controlled light pressure. The honing head is not guided externally but instead floats in the hole and being guided by the work surface. It is desired that honing stones should not leave the work surface. Stroke length must cover the entire work length. Honing is a finishing process by a honing tool which contains a set of 3 or 2 dozen and more bonded abrasive sticks. The sticks are equally spaced about the periphery of the honing tool. They are held against the work surface with a controlled light pressure, usually exercised with small strings. The honing tool is given a complex rotational auxiliary axle motion which combines to produce a cross hatch layer pattern of very low surface finish. Stone, aluminum oxide, silicon, boron, silicon carbide bonded abrasives. The critical process parameters are rotational speed, oscillation speed, length and position of the stroke, honing stick pressure. The parameters that affect the material removal rate and surface roughness are unit pressure, peripheral honing speed and honing timing. Super finishing. Super finishing is a micro finishing process that produces a controlled surface condition on cloth which is not obtained by any other method. The operation, which is also called as micro stoning, consists of scrubbing a stone against the surface to produce a fine quality metal finish. The process consists of removing chattered marks and fragmented or smeared metal from the surface of dimensional finished parts. As much as 0.03 to 0.05 mm of stock can be efficiently removed with some production applications. The process becomes most economic if the material remains limited to 0.005 mm. Thank you.